Kia ora, tūra waka o. The Pasifika Music Awards are on at the Dewdrop Event Centre, Manukau, next week. It'll be the 19th edition, can you believe it, of these awards. And this year, 24 artists have been nominated across 13 award categories. And one of those multi-category nominees is the fabulous R&B artist Sam V, who joins us now for our Talanoa. Sam, kia ora ana. Thank you for coming in on the show.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
We appreciate it. Now, you're up for, how many awards? Four categories you're up this year. Best Pacific Male Artist. I'm going to go through them. Best Pacific Music Song. Best Pacific Soul R&B Artist. And yeah. Best Producer. How does it feel?
I'm just happy to be there, to be honest. Last year was my first time being nominated for something, and then this year was my second time. And to go from being someone who was just stoked to be involved and to be able to perform to now being like a co-leading nominee is crazy. It's been a pretty quick ascension, but I'm really happy to be representing Polynesian
and up there with some pretty big names. And for example, the artist category, male artist Lepani Mallow Downs, and also Victor J. Seffel as well.
Great blokes.
I mean, the whole raft of nominations, finalists who are in these awards, it's really such an array of talent, isn't it?
For sure. It's a great class. I'm really happy to be considered amongst my peers. So just happy to be here and to contribute, to be involved is great.
Tell us about your own career. Yeah. You've been in the game for 10 years, although you started young, 25 now.
Yeah, I'm old. I got knee pain and stuff. We're struggling out here.
Tell us what it's been like for you and how hard is it to be making it now?
It's been a long journey, to be honest. I moved into music full-time last year. I was signed freshly when I was 11 and again at 13, and I've been independent from the age of 16. It's definitely hard, but I feel like I've never thought about doing music as a career. It's just what I do. It's like breathing. It's second nature. But for artists, it's definitely tough. We have to be content creators too now. You can't just be a great singer or songwriter. You've got to be keep your thumb on the pulse of all the different social media platforms and stay relevant, stay trending. So I definitely feel for young artists in that regards, but we just got to do it. Means to an end. It's how we get our music out there.
And who's influenced you? Who do you...
Musically or...?
Yeah.
Oh, Brandy's my favourite. I think she's the greatest singer of all time. Yeah, just love Brandy. Shout out to Brandy.
Oh, nice, man. And you've just got back, speaking of, you've just come back from the States. Tell us how the trip went down and why you decided to foray out there.
Well, me and the boys have been talking about going over there for a long time, 10 years now. So we figured, well, we're doing music full time. There's no excuse. Let's do it while we got no kids. We're still kind of young buck to some extent, you know what
Nothing
I mean?
Nothing holding you back.
Aside from the knee pain. but we you know, traded over. There's four of us. And we went over pretty cold, to be honest.
You didn't know anyone over there?
We knew a handful of people. And I just did what I needed to do to get
what
my name out
goal?
There. I think my goal was to tap into the scene and to leave with a completed EP, and to leave with a community of people that resonated with me and that I could tap into. So I've left with a bit of a family. Yes, for sure. I've got uncles there now, the people owning me, and it's great. I love it.
So you on the open mic scene there, like plugging away every night?
Three, four nights a week.
Wow,
yeah.
Good
just
on you.
The best way to meet people is visibility. So, you know, you have to go out there and hustle and do what you do. So I can perform live. I'm all right at that. So go out there and do my thing. Yeah, for sure.
What about the local scene? How hard is it to be getting gigs here in Aotearoa?
It's tough. I remember when I was younger, it was something I had gripes with. I felt frustrated because I wasn't being booked for shows. But I think my advice is to book your own shows.
Nice.
Venues are, you know, pretty reasonably cheap. There's one on K Road called The Wine Cellar, which is $200.
Oh, wow.
Go book it, young bucks.
I better
do your
go.
Thing. Oh, you can do a show. Do one with John. Stand up.
I should.
Yeah, come on.
No, I'll leave you to do the singing, Sam. actually, speaking of, you mentioned your influence before with Brandy, but what about culturally? Tell us a little bit about your heritage. You're Cook Islander as well as Dutch.
Yeah, Cook Islander.
What's your heritage in the Cook Islands?
From Manga Aitutaki. So Manga, my villages are Tamaroa, Oniroa. And I'm gradually getting to meet my relatives more and more as my name gets a little bit more out there. They're coming out of the woodwork.
Yeah. So,
nice. Hello, put the hand out as well. But I'm just, super eager to get to know my culture a little bit more because something I didn't necessarily grow up with too strong connection-wise. So hopefully I can meet more and more as I progress, become older.
And what about language? How much do you understand or speak?
Swear words and songs,
yes,
basic
exactly.
greetings.
Okay.
Yeah, very simple.
I mean, that's the reality for a lot of New Zealand-raised Cook Islanders.
For sure.
I think 9% of Cook Islanders in New Zealand are fluent.
Oh, really?
Or can speak it, really. But what about yourself? In terms of your identity, how important is it?
I'm proud. I'm super proud to be from the Cook Islands and to represent my people and to put you know, Polynesian music on the map as well as cookie music. So it's something that I hold super, super dear and strong to my heart. Yeah, for sure.
Well, you are doing it. You are doing the damage. And I just want to say all the best.
Thank you very much for having me.
For the awards next week. Hopefully you're going to take away some. And I've got to hear just some of the people who are performing. I know you performed last year, but this year it's Mellow Downs, Levani. Ooh.
Come on.
Luana and Jordan with a Y. And there's also going to be a very special tribute for a lifetime achievement to Tony Williams as well. So it's going to be a great show.
Exciting. Better pull up, boys and girls. It's going to be a great night.
Sam V, mei taki mata.
Mei taki mata.
Thank you so much for coming on the show. All the best with your career as well.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.